Well, just so you know, my apologies to you if Netflix is still around when you're alive, because I'm probably gonna hardly pay any attention to you. I'm just gonna be watching that 24/7. I'm gonna make a really bad parent. Sorry. Our theme is advice, and I decided to make an advice video for my future children. I'd like to say that I probably do not want to have kids. I don't think I can deal with the whole idea of, like, labor, and I don't think I can deal with kids constantly asking me for money, and I don't think I can deal with messy rooms all the time. I don't think I can deal with nasty laundry or diapers or, I don't know, whatever kids do. I don't think I can deal with that. So I really don't want to have kids, but, you know, sometimes you change your mind as you get older, so if I do ever change my mind and decide to have kids, I decided to make an advice video that I really appreciate that they watch. First of all, if I'm gonna be your parent, you're probably gonna end up a really messed up kid, and I'm so very, very sorry. I'm a messed up person, and I'm not gonna be very good at anything. But I do want to be somebody whose shoulder you can cry on when you're sad, or somebody who you can just talk to without me judging you or being mad at you or any of the sort. I want you to be happy with your life, and I don't want me having anything to do with what you do with your life. I want you to do what makes you happy and what you can make a good living off of. I don't want you to be running back to me as soon as you leave the house. I mean, it's fine if you visit, it's fine if you come back, hang out with me a little bit, but honestly, once you leave the house, honey, you're not coming back. You're not allowed to live in my basement, because my basement is gonna be where I probably keep everything that I've ever wanted down there. Like, all the stuff that you've always had in your room that I never wanted, I'm probably just gonna put it down in the basement, and you're just gonna be sitting there surrounded by God knows what. So I'm not letting you back into the house, and I am so very sorry, because after you leave, I'm gonna be happy, okay? I'm gonna miss you and all that, but man, life without you is pretty dang easy. I want my kids to know that they will never, ever, ever be without anybody that loves them. There's always gonna be at least somebody out there that loves them, and it's always gonna be me, of course, but if, you know, one day I die or something like that, and I really don't want that to happen, but whenever they feel like there's nobody who loves them, I want them to know that there is somebody who loves them, whether it be their future father, or their siblings, or their cousins, or aunties, or grandmas and grandpas, or, I don't know, significant others. I just want them to know there's always gonna be somebody who will be there for them and who loves them very much. I don't want my kids to be afraid of being themselves near me or near anybody they know. If one day my kids come out to me as whatever they are, I just want to be fully supportive of them. I want them to be happy with their lives. That's all I could ever want for my kids. I want them to know that they're not gonna be alone. They're never gonna be the only one. There's always gonna be somebody else who's a lot like them, who's going through the same thing. It may not be me, because, you know, completely different age groups go through completely different things, but there's always gonna be someone who's going through the same thing as them, and they're never gonna be alone. They're never gonna be the only ones going through something. They're never gonna stand out in front of people. But I want them to know they better stand out. If my kids ever even try to do something to fit in, I'm probably not gonna let them do it. If their excuse is that whatever they're doing will make them popular, I'm not gonna let them do it. Unless what they're doing is legit fun, then I will not let them do it. If they want to do something stupid, like, I don't know, get a weird haircut because all the cool kids have that haircut, I won't let them do it, because I know that they probably don't want that haircut. They just doing it because followers will come in. I don't want my kids to be thirsty for fame or popularity or just society in general to like them. I don't want my kids to be conscious that there's people out there that don't like them. I want my kids to know there's going to always be haters, and there's always going to be somebody that does not appreciate what you're doing. And let me just say, it's never going to be me. That's one of my goals in life, is never to be someone that stops my kids from doing what they love and what will make them happy for the rest of their lives. I don't want that person to be me, and I'm going to try my best not to be that person. And if I fail on you, then just please forgive me. I'm completely not going to be myself if I fail on you with that. If you want to be like a tattoo artist because you just think the whole idea of art on the body, I guess, is neat, I'm going to be like, okay, at least you're making a living. Hey, we can't all be winners. I want my kids to have friends that don't gossip about them behind their back, and friends that also think I'm cool because I want to be a cool mom. Like,
I'm a cool mom.
I want my kids to live while they're young because they're only young one time, and that time is very, very vital to how they are later in life. And I want them to just be who they are with their friends and live life to the very fullest, because they never know if they're going to be gone from this earth the next day. So they might as well have the time of their life while they can. I want them to try something new every single day. I want them to step out of their comfort zone, whether it's talking to somebody that you've never talked to before, whether it's trying something you've never tried before, such as food. I just want them to step out of that comfort zone and be bold about it. I want my kids to be very, very confident in themselves, especially if I have daughters, because I don't want society to be the ones that tell them how they should look. I want them to look how they want themselves to look, how they want to appear to others, how they feel the most comfortable, and I don't want them to be pushed into some sort of bandwagon that makes them think they should look a certain way. It's a little out of date just because it kind of fits with this generation, but I hope it helps the next generation in this world, and I hope the next generation is better than this generation. And the last thing I want to say is just be better than your mother and your father. Just keep doing better things than us.